I'm Hans Christian Andersen, I've many a tale to tell, and though I'm a cobbler, I'd say I tell them rather well. I'll mend your shoes and I'll fix your boots when I have a moment free, when I'm not otherwise occupied as a purple duck or a mountainside or a quarter after three. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, Andersen, that's me. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, I bring you a fable rare. There once was a table who said, oh, how I'd love a chair. And then and there came a sweet young chair, all dressed in a bridal gown. He said to her in a voice so true, now I did not say I would marry you, but I would like to sit down. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, Andersen's in town. I write myself a note each day and I place it in my hat. The wind comes by, the hat blows high, but that's not the end of that. For round and round the world it goes, it lands here right behind myself. I pick it up and I read the note, which is merely to remind myself. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, Andersen, that's me. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, my pen's like a babbling brook. Permit me to show you, dear sir, my very latest book. Now here's a tale of a simple fool, just glance at a page or two. You laugh, ha ha, but you blush a bit, for you realize while you're reading it that it's also reading you. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, Andersen, that's who. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, and this is an April day. It's full of the magic I need to speed me on my way. My pocketbook has an empty look, I limp on a lumpy shoe. Or if I wish, I'm a flying fish or a millionaire with a rocking chair and a dumpling in my stew. I'm Hans Christian Andersen, Andersen, that's who.
They welcomed me. Her eyes were fire bright. And then I knew that my path must be through the ever haunted night. Anywhere I heart will find no home. Anywhere I wander, anywhere I roam. Her voice was, oh, such a soft caress of love it gently told. And in her smile was the tenderness I may never more behold.
Anywhere I wander,
There once was an ugly duckling with feathers all stubby and brown. And the other birds in so many words said, get out of town. Get out, get out, get out of town. And he went with a quack and a waddle and a quack in a flurry of eiderdown. That poor little ugly duckling went wandering far and near, but at every place they said to his face, now get out of here. Get out, get out, get out of here. And he went with a quack and a waddle and a quack and a very unhappy tear. All through the winter time he hid himself away, ashamed to show his face, afraid of what others might say. All through the winter in his lonely clump of weed, till a flock of swans spied him there and very soon agreed, you're a very fine swan indeed. A swan? Me a swan? Ah, go on. And he said, yes, you're a swan. Take a look at yourself in the lake and you'll see. And he looked and he saw and he said, I am a swan. Whee! I'm not such an ugly duckling. No feathers, all stubby and brown. For in fact, these birds in so many words said, the best in town. The best, the best, the best in town. Not a quack, not a waddle or a quack, but a glide and a whistle and a snowy white back. And a head so noble and a heart. Say, who's an ugly duckling? Not I. Not I.
Two and two are four. Four and four are eight. Eight and eight are 16. 16 and 16 are 32.
Measuring the marigold, you and your arithmetic, you'll probably go far. Inchworm, inchworm, measuring the marigold, seems to me you'd stop and see how beautiful they are. Measuring the marigold,
You and your arithmetic, you'll probably go far. Inchworm, measuring the marigold, seems to me you'd stop and see how beautiful they are. To me you'd stop and see how beautiful they are. Seems to me you'd stop and see how beautiful.
Thumbelina, Thumbelina, tiny little thing. Thumbelina, dance. Thumbelina, sing. Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small? When your heart is full of love, you're 9 feet tall. Though you're no bigger than my thumb.
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 Sweet Thumbelina, don't be glum.
Don't be glum.
Now, now, now. Come, come, come.
Thumbelina, Thumbelina, tiny little thing. Thumbelina, dance. Thumbelina, sing. Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small? When your heart is full of love, you're 9 feet
than my toe.
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 Sweet Thumbelina, keep that glow.
Keep that glow.
And you'll grow, and you'll grow, and you'll grow. Oh, Thumbelina, Thumbelina, tiny little thing. Thumbelina, dance. Thumbelina, sing.
Oh, Thumbelina, what's the difference if you're very small? When your heart is full of love, you're 9 feet tall.
No two people have ever been so in love, been so in love, been so in love.
No two people have ever been so in love as my lovey-dove and I.
No two people have ever mooned such a moon, June such a June, spoon such a spoon.
No two people have ever been so in tune as my macaroon and I.
And when we kiss, and when we kiss, well, it's hysterical, it's historical.
Let me tell it.
Well, certainly, darling.
No two people have ever been so in love.
Are you just saying?
Been so in love.
Are you kidding?
Been so in love.
Really? No two people have ever been so in love as my lovely dove and I.
Never before and never again can
never
anything
before
more
and ever again. No two people have ever been so in love.
Been so in love.
Been so in love.
Been so in love.
Been so in
it's
love.
It's incredible. No two people have ever been so in love.
Been so
as my lovey dove and
I.
This is unique, the positive peak. Oh, we are the most unusual couple on
no
earth.
No two people have ever mooned such a moon.
Moon such a moon.
June such a June.
June such a June.
Spoon such a
what
spoon.
What he means is that no two people have ever been so in tune.
Been so as
my macaroon and I.
And when we kiss.
And when we kiss.
And when we kiss.
Well, it's like this.
Well, it's hysterical. It's historical.
Let me tell it.
Be my guest, dear.
And no two people have ever been so in love.
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 It's impossible, no two people. people have ever been so in
been
love
so as my lovey dove. And I. This is the cream, the very extreme, the sort of a dream you couldn't
well,
imagine
anyway,
at all.
Well, anyway, no two people have ever been so in
been
love.
Been so as my lovey dove and I.
This is the story of the king's new clothes. Now, there was once a king who was absolutely insane about new clothes, and one day, two swindlers came to sell him what they said was a magic suit of clothes. Now, they held up this particular garment, and they said, "Your Majesty, this is a magic suit." Well, the truth of the matter is, there was no suit there at all. But the swindlers were very smart, and they said, "Your Majesty, to a wise man, this is a beautiful raiment, but to a fool, it is absolutely invisible."
Well, naturally, the king, not wanting to appear a fool, said, "Isn't it grand? Isn't it fine? Look at the cut, the style, the line. The suit of clothes is altogether, but altogether, it's altogether the most remarkable suit of clothes that I have ever seen. These eyes of mine at once determined, the sleeves are velvet, the cape is ermine, the hose are blue, and the doublet is a lovely shade of green.
Lovely shade of green."
"Somebody send for the queen."
Well, they sent for the queen, and they quickly explained to her about the magic suit of clothes. And naturally, the queen, not wanting to appear a fool, said, "Well, isn't it, oh, isn't it rich? Look at the charm of every stitch. The suit of clothes is altogether, but altogether, it's altogether the most remarkable suit of clothes that I have ever seen. These eyes of mine at once determined, the sleeves are velvet, the cape is ermine, the hose are blue, and the doublet is a lovely shade of green.
Lovely shade of green."
"Summon the court to convene."
Well, the court convened, and you never in your life saw as many people as were at that court. All the ambassadors, the dukes, the earls, the counts, it was just black with people. And they were all told about the magic suit of clothes. And after they were told, they naturally didn't want to appear fools, and they said, "Isn't it, oh, isn't it, ah, isn't it absolutely? The suit of clothes is altogether, but altogether, it's altogether the most remarkable suit of clothes a tailor ever made. Now quickly, put it all together with gloves of leather and hat and feather. It's altogether the thing to wear in Saturday's parade.
Saturday's parade!
Leading the royal brigade."
Now Saturday came, and the streets were just lined with thousands and thousands and thousands of people. And they all were cheering as the artillery came by, the infantry marched by, the cavalry galloped by, and everybody was cheering like mad, except one little boy. You see, he hadn't heard about the magic suit and didn't know what he was supposed to see. Well, as the king came by, the little boy looked and, horrified, said, "Look at the king! Look at the king! Look at the king! The king! The king! The king is in the altogether, but altogether, the altogether, he's altogether as naked as the day that he was born. The king is in the altogether, but altogether, the altogether, it's altogether the very least the king has ever worn.
Call the court physician! Call an intermission! His Majesty is wide open to ridicule and scorn.
The king is in the altogether, but altogether, the altogether, he's altogether as naked as the day that he was born.
And it's altogether too chilly a morn." Wonderful, wonderful Copenhagen, friendly old girl of town.
Neath her tavern light on this merry night,
let us clink and drink one down.
Once I sailed away, but I'm home today,
singing Copenhagen, wonderful, wonderful Copenhagen for me.
I sail up the Skagi Rack and sail down the Kattegat, through the harbor and up to the quay, and there she stands waiting for me with a welcome so warm and so gay.
Wonderful, wonderful Copenhagen.
Wonderful, wonderful tavern light on this merry night.
Let us drink and drink one glass to wonderful, wonderful Copenhagen, salty old queen of the sea.
Once I sailed away, but I'm home today,
singing Copenhagen, wonderful, wonderful Copenhagen for me.
Manic Depressive Pictures present Hello, Fresno, goodbye. Produced by our Manic and directed by Depressive.
Now you know the name of the picture and you'd like to see it. But no.
Screenplay by Gluck, from a stage play by Motz, from a story by Blip, from a chapter by Ronk, from a sentence by Dopes, from a comma by Stokes, from an idea by Grokes, based on a Joe Miller's a jokes.
Now you know the name of the picture and who wrote it, and you'd still like to see it. But no. Art direction, Finkel Puff and Teary is Minerva Buff photography. Alonzo Tech record is sound as Needleback upholstery by Zachary, Nick Knackery by Thackeray, Tuxickery by Dickery, and Dickery by Doc.
Now finally, finally at last, comes the picture. And what do we see?
The same old beautiful Corvus girls.
The opening scene is a ranch in Fresno, California. So what are they singing?
When it's cherry blossom time in Orange, New Jersey, we'll make a peach of a pear. I know we can't elope, so honey, do be mine. And if
up from the gulch rides a hunk of man, he is a hero, Cowboy Dan, a galloping, yodeling buckaroo. His horse, of course, is a baritone, too. I've got that wagon wheels inside of me. I've got that old cactus in the hide of me. I've got that.
The girls are delighted to hear this. But where is our heroine? As the bell rings for lunch, we find our heroine in the corral, eating her heart out. She is Mary Swann, tap-dancing daughter of an American juggling act who left her on the doorstep of an old English castle where she was found by Sir Basil Metabolism, who said,
"By Jove, a girl, baby! I shall raise her as my own daughter,"
which he did. But she wants to tap-dance a Cowboy Dan who she met on this trip and whose love at first sight wants to marry her, so she can tap-dance, but she knows Sir Basil will never permit this. Never, never, never!
That's why she's eating her heart out.
But through her tears, she is singing a happy little song, because she is also a coloratura soprano. She is beside herself. Her favorite position.
Oh, Father, you must let me marry Cowboy Dan. He owns the biggest ranch in Texas, bar none.
Bar none? Well, that's the password of the FBI. It can't be. No, no, yes, yes, no, no, yes, yes, no, no, yes, yes, no, no, yes, yes, it can't be.
But it was.
He rushes to Mary Swann. Mary Swann, you must help me out. Can you tap out a message in code? This is her big chance. Now she can tap dance, which she does. But what has she done? She has betrayed her own father. But he isn't her father.
Hier ist Heinrich, mein Schlupen, mein rotes Flömen, heidende Glube, der Ölske Schmerzen, der Hassen, der Ulde, der Helme, der Helme, der Flomen, der Geplange, der Ölze und Ulme, der Hass knallt mit der Ölden, der Grone, Ölzen, der Hals, der Geheul, der Mnini, der The Dangerous German Spy. Stick up your hands, you dirty ratten, cowardice, blight, and eitin' blad. So, the FBI finally captured the German spy. Dan and Mary are about to blend. You think the picture's about to end? But no. Who ever heard of a musical picture without Carmelita Pepita, the Bolivian bombshell? I wish you would come with me to my little village in Bolivia. So peaceful there are the purple mountains with the lovely mist and the shining stars. And the little people who live so simple and quiet. And every night, all they want to do is grab a partner, swing away, a cherub, awesome, lime, and orange, and jay. Grab her by the teeth and swing her by the hair, and you will make a peach of a pair. Oh, grab! So here we are, back in Fresno, California. And this is where you came in. But do not fret, my friend. This is a picture that ends in the middle for the benefit of the people who came in the middle. This is the end. It all began when I was born a month too soon. My ma was frightened by a runaway saloon. Pa was forced to be a hobo because he played the oboe, and the oboe, it is clearly understood, is an ill wind that no one blows good. I'll never forget the morning that Grandpa ate the awning to impress a pretty lady who went for men that were shady. Then my Uncle Josiah lit the great Frisco fire, ran off to Hawaii with the old Erie cow, which his loving wife resented, and thereupon invented a rolling pin that strikes and then says, pow. And I'm the result of the twisted eugenics of this family of inbred schizophrenics, the end of a long, long line of pets I design. Women's hats. I'm Anatole LaPalace, I shriek with chic, my hat of the week, cause six divorces, three runaway horses. I'm Anatole LaPalace, the hats I sell make husbands yell, is that a hat or a two-room flat? Let me get my paw on a little piece of straw, and voila, a chapeau at $60 a throw. It's how I pull and chew on it, the little things I do on it, like placing yards of lacing or a bicycle bill for two on it. The little ones, the big ones, the sat on by a pig ones, the foolish ones that belch and the ghoulish ones that lurch. The one called whiskey sour, designed for the cocktail hour, a little snip of potato chip and a trifle of the Eiffel Tower. I am Anatole of Paris, I must design, I'm just like wine, I go to your head. Give me thread and the needle, I itch, I twitch to stitch, I'm a glutton for cutting, for putting with a button to snip and plug, nip and tug, fix and trim, from the trim, tote back, part, to lift the veil. And why do I sew each new chapeau with the style they must look positively grim in? Strictly between us, entre nous, I hate women.
Po, 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 the puppet. Po, 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 the puppet. Po, 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 the puppet. The fellow that you ought to know.
Popo the puppet can do anything, a thing, a thing, a thing. Popo can fly though he hasn't a wing, a wing, a wing, a wing. He can juggle a prune, blow up a balloon, or tickle a tune on the piano. He can fly a kite in spite of his height and sing both in bass and soprano. Popo the puppet can jump through a ring, swing on a swing, spring on a spring. Yes, Popo the puppet can do anything when somebody else pulls the string, the string, the string, the string, when somebody else pulls the string.
I hope someday you can see Popo. He's a most unusual fella. His eyes are purple and his nose is pink. And his hair, oh, that's a remarkable yellow.
Popo can bark.
Oh, 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 oh.
Sing like a lark.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
Moo like a cow.
Moo.
Do like a sow.
Oink.
Sound a note just like a goat.
Meh.
Popo can blow like an automobile.
Beep.
Go like a seal.
Wah.
Then like a hen.
Blah.
Popo the puppet can do anything
if somebody else pulls the string.
The string, the string, the string. If somebody else pulls the string.
Popo the puppet can do anything. A thing, a thing, a thing. He never bumps when he jumps through a ring, a ring, a ring, a ring. He can stand on his head while making his bed and then in a minute get in it. He can do any trick that you can pick and then in addition arithmetic. Popo the puppet can jump through a ring, swing on a swing, spring on a spring. Yes, Popo the puppet can do anything, and he did it.
How?
And he did it.
Where?
And he did it.
Why?
And he did it.
When
somebody else pulled the string.
Oh!
When somebody else pulled the string.
Sing!
When somebody else pulled the string.
The string, the string, the string. When somebody else pulled the string.
See?
Bye.
First you put your tunies close up tight. You swing 'em to the left and then you swing 'em to the right. Step around the floor kinda nice and light. And then you twist around with all of your might. Spread your loving arms way out in space. You do the eagle rock with such style and grace. You put your left foot out and then you bring it back. That's what I call balling the jack.
Oh, don't do me that way. Listen to that man go. He's crazy. I swear he's crazy. Oh, dear. Now follow me closely, real close on this one, and do me after me.
First you put your two knees close up tight. Real close. Swing 'em to the left and then you swing 'em to the right.
Oh, you're delicious.
Step around the floor, kinda nice and light. And then you twist around with all of your might. Spread your loving arms way out in space. You do the eagle rock with such style and grace. You put your left foot out and then you bring it back. That's what I call ball and the jack.